Hello everyone, myself Dr. M.SRUJAN Kumar. My education background is pharmacy. Today's topic is surface tension and interfacial tension concept. Before going on to the topic, as today's world we are fighting against pandemic COVID-19, in order to ensure coronavirus safety, please follow these easy steps to help prevent the spread of COVID-19. First, disinfect surface around your home and work. Second, wash your hands for at least 20 seconds. Third, sneeze or cough, cover your mouth. Have you ever imagined what would be the reason for the water droplet to maintain its spherical shape? Here, I have quoted two images. One is water sprinkled on the leaf, the other one is raindrops on the surface of the glass. It is not about these two images. Any water you sprinkle on the surface, on any surface, ultimately that particular water droplet will acquire a spherical shape. Have you ever thought what would be the reason? The reason is nothing but it is due to surface tension. Now, what is this surface tension? In what way this surface tension will help water droplet to maintain its spherical shape? Now we will move on to the definition of surface tension. The property of the surface of a liquid that allows it to resist an external force due to the cohesive nature of its molecules. Did we understand anything from the definition? I think no. First, we need to understand the concept involved in surface tension. Consider a glass containing water. Water is nothing but a liquid medium. Okay, this particular water is made up of what? Water molecules. So, we need to make two observations here. One is, water molecules that are present inside the bulk of the liquid, and the second one is water molecules that are present on the surface of the liquid. Can you see the image that has been displayed here? You can see at the center a water molecule that has been highlighted in red. So this particular water molecule is equally attracted in all the directions by the surrounding water molecules. Surrounding water molecules are nothing but called as neighboring water molecules. As it is equally attracted in all the directions, here the net resultant force is zero. Okay, so this is the first case. Molecules in bulk experience these attractive forces in all directions. The net resultant force is zero. So when you say attractive forces, here the attractive forces are nothing but cohesive forces. Okay, and second, the molecules, water molecules which are floating on the surface of the liquid medium, these particular water molecules will not be attracted in all the directions, because if you can observe the image, there are the missing water molecules above the surface. So above the surface there are missing water molecules. Due to this reason, there is an interface that will be established between your liquid and your air. Due to this interface, there exists a tension. That particular tension is called as surface tension. So, as this particular tension is established here, what happens here? This particular surface layer acts as an elastic layer. It forms a film on the surface, due to which the blade floats on the water and the water striders will float on the water. Even if you want to add something onto the water, that particular powder or any kind of substance, it will not dissolve readily. Why? Because of this surface tension. And you can also experience the example, like as I told you before, that if you sprinkle water droplet onto the surface, this particular water droplet, when you put an external force onto the droplet, this particular water droplet will resist the external force. Why? Because of the missing neighboring water molecules on the surface of your water droplet. There exists a tension. That tension is nothing but called as a surface tension. And what are the forces that are responsible here? The forces are nothing but called as your cohesive forces. If you can see the second point, molecules at surface formed between liquid and gas. Liquid and gas, nothing but such as air, do not have neighbors of same kind on all the sides. As I told you that the water molecules that are present on the surface will not be equally attracted from all the sides. Even you can see the image also here. Bottom side you can see there is an attractive water molecules. Left side you can see there is an attractive water molecule. Right side you can see an attractive. But at the top portion you cannot see any water molecule present. That is nothing but, these are nothing but called as missing neighbors. Due to that missing neighbors, here exists a tension. That tension is called as surface tension. So in a simple way we can say that surface tension is an interface formed between liquid and gas, and gas is nothing but called as air. This is the concept involved in surface tension. If you redefine the definition, the property of the surface of the liquid that allows it to resist an external phase due to the cohesive nature of its molecules. Did you got my point? Yes. This is another image displayed to explain the surface tension. The cohesive forces among the liquid molecules are responsible for this phenomena, as we said previously. Okay, can you see here? On the left hand side, you can see a water molecule that has missing neighbors at the surface. On the right hand side, you can see a water molecule that is equally attracted in all the directions. The water molecule that has been equally attracted in all the directions will be present inside the bulk of the liquid. But the water molecules that will be present on the surface of your liquid medium, there will be a missing neighbors. Due to this missing neighbor, there exists a tension called as surface tension. Where it will exist surface tension? At the interface between your liquid and air. Okay. Yet another image to explain concept of surface tension. Here the image has been depicted. It is something like a beaker containing water. You can see a surface layer, and above your surface layer there is an air, and below your surface layer there is a liquid. On the left hand side and right hand side you can see a water molecule that is equally attracted in all the directions, and the net resultant force is zero. And you can see a water molecule that has been floating on the surface. It has missing neighbors. That missing neighbors can be represented as dotted circles. Okay, and here on the surface it establishes some tension, and that particular tension is nothing but called as surface tension. By that surface tension, your particular surface layer of any water droplet will behave as an film or something. If that film has a property of elastic property, okay, to a particular extent it will resist an external force. It is an imaginary one. Normally you touch a water droplet, okay, and just see what happens to that water droplet. Just it will withstand that external pressure to some extent. If you put more force onto that particular droplet, it will just collapse. Okay, and when it get collapse, ultimately it will get divided into small droplets again. Ultimately here the point is that what is the thing that is responsible to maintain spherical shape for a water droplet? Nothing but it is a surface tension. Many times we see these things into our day-to-day life, but will not understand what is happening exactly. What is the phenomenon involved? The phenomenon is nothing but called as surface tension phenomena. You can see cohesive forces to neighboring molecules, missing cohesive forces to neighboring molecule. Missing cohesive forces to neighboring molecules can be observed on the surface of your liquid. And cohesive forces to neighboring molecules, you can observe the water molecules that are inside the bulk of the liquid. Next, yet another image to explain still better about the phenomenon of surface tension. You can see A, B, C here. A is a water molecule that is equally attracted in all the direction. B is a water molecule. 80% of that particular water molecule will be attracted downwards, and 20% that has been attracted upwards. And in the case of C, you can see 50% is attracted downwards and 50% is attracted upwards. So if you can observe, A will be having neighboring molecules attracted in all the directions, so the net resultant force is zero. So when you compare this B and C, C will be having more surface tension, B will be having less surface tension. Why? Because major amount of B water molecule is immersed inside the bulk of the liquid, but in the case of C, half of the portion is above and half of the portion is below. This is another image to explain the phenomenon of surface tension. So any droplet you see, it is just imagine that the droplet that has concave nature, that means that concave nature, that is nothing but a surface, and inside which you will be having n number of water molecules that are present in the bulk. So droplet is not like one water molecule. Droplet contains many number of water molecules. Okay, got my point? Yeah. Now we will move on to concept of surface tension in pharmaceutical dosage form. So in what way this surface tension will influence the formulation development of pharmaceutical dosage forms? So especially surface tension phenomena will be used in liquid type of dosage form. Okay, this liquid type of dosage forms are divided into monophasic and biphasic liquid dosage form. Ultimately, monophasic liquid dosage forms are nothing but homogeneous systems, and biphasic liquid dosage forms are nothing but heterogeneous systems. Sorry, it's a typo error on the slide. So homogeneous systems, like examples are gargles, mouthwashes, lotions, eye drops, ear drops, etc. And heterogeneous systems, examples are your suspension. First, we'll discuss monophasic liquid dosage form. What is the criteria for the selection of drug to formulate monophasic liquid dosage form? The drug should be soluble in nature. So what happens when you add a soluble API to a liquid medium? So here the observation is major amount of the API gets dissolved and the remaining API will be floating on water. What would be the reason? So it is nothing but there is an air entrapment on the surface of the particle, and due to the surface tension also, the particle cannot get inside the liquid medium. So how you can avoid this? You can avoid this by adding wetting agent. What wetting agents will do? When you add wetting agents, they'll displace the air entrapped onto the particle. After that, they will enter into the core of the particle. Thereby, it will solubilize the particle, nothing but wet the particle. Thereby, it will dissolve the particle into the liquid medium. This is how wetting agents will help to reduce the surface tension, thereby helps the particle to get dissolved inside the liquid medium. Did you understand? Next, we'll move on to biphasic liquid dosage form. What is the criteria for the selection of a drug to be formulated into a biphasic liquid dosage form? That particular drug or API should be insoluble in nature. The first example is suspension. So what happens when you add insoluble API to a liquid medium? Here, the observation is some amount of API gets dispersed, and the remaining API will be floating on water. So before adding surfactant, you can see a picture in which you have added your drug and little amount of the drug get dispersed into the liquid medium and the remaining is floating on the water. What would be the reason? Here again, it's the same reason. It is because of the air entrapped onto the particle and surface tension. How you are going to avoid this? You can use surface active agents or surfactants. These surface active agents or surfactants will reduce the surface tension, thereby it will help the particle to get dispersed into your water. Next, what is the concept of interfacial tension? So, surface tension concept and interfacial tension concepts both are similar. The only difference is the interfacial tension is an interface formed between two immersible faces. What do you mean by surface tension? Surface tension is an interface formed between liquid phase and gas phase, nothing but called as air. But interfacial tension is the interface formed between two immiscible phases. This interfacial tension as biphasic liquid dosage form. Under that, the second example called as emulsions. What happens when you add oil to water? Ultimately, oil and water will remain as a separate layer. When this oil and water, as it remains as a separate layer, can we prepare an emulsion? No, it is not possible. What we require here is water should get dispersed as small droplets into oil, or oil should get dispersed into water as small droplet. This is a phenomena what we need in order to prepare an emulsion. So, what is the observation when you add oil to water? Why oil cannot disperse into water as small globules and vice versa? As I explained, reason, because of the interface formed between two phases, and as a result, interfacial tension exists between two phases. Until and unless you don't break this interfacial tension, because as we know that oil and water are two immiscible phases. As we said, when you mix oil with water, until ultimately there is an interface formed between two phases. So as there is an interface formed between two immiscible phases, here exists a tension. That tension is nothing but called as interfacial tension. What is the solution here? When we break this interfacial tension, then only we can prepare a stable emulsion. How the interfacial tension can be reduced? That interfacial tension can be reduced by adding a surfactant or emulsifier or emulsifying agent. This surfactant or emulsifier or emulsifying agent will help the formulation to reduce the interfacial tension, thereby it will enhance the stability of emulsion. And here we come. There is a good literature for understanding. So sodium lauryl sulfate acts as a wetting agent, surfactant, surface active agent, emulsifier and emulsifying agent. So throughout these slides, you have been in a confusion, I hope so. Like, what is this wetting agent? What is the example for wetting agent? What is the example for surfactant? What is the example for emulsifier or emulsifying agent? So all these three terminologies, principle is same. They reduce the tension. So it might be a surface tension, it might be an interfacial tension. Based upon the formulation development of a suitable type of a dosage form, in monophasic you will be using sodium lauryl sulfate as a wetting agent. In the case of suspensions, you will be using sodium lauryl sulfate as a surfactant or surface active agent. While preparing your emulsions, you will be using same sodium lauryl sulfate as emulsifier or emulsifying agent. Don't be in confusion, just look for the application of this agent, what exactly it will do in your formulation. The application is same for all the three to reduce the tension. Okay, thank you for listening and thank you for watching my video. Thank you very much.